Hey everybody, this is Ann Clemmer. Oh, welcome to the show. It is Good Friday and it is really a good Friday. I'm here with Stamper from stamperdog.com. Let's get started.
Stamper, come.
Do you have your Easter hat on? I got my Easter hat on. Oh, did I put it on here right? I'm not sure. You know, my bangs are a little bit long to be wearing a hat, but I am so blessed. How about you? Oh, Liz is here. Oh, my goodness. Yeah. You know, it's kind of weird because if you know anything about the resurrection story, Friday, they call it Good Friday, but it was an awful sad day. And if you, you know, I mean, oh my goodness. But, and if you think about the bad parts of it, you know, then, and like you watch some of these shows that are really graphic, you really kind of appreciate what happened a few thousand years ago. And then now, you just have to remember, you know, Sunday's coming and it's right around the corner, and that's why I love Easter so much. So I changed my settings last night for the audio. So if I'm distorting or if it's too loud or too soft, please let me know. It's really hard for me to check my own audio because, you know, I'm a solopreneur. And then, see, this is the right idea. I'm a solopreneur and, you know, I could go and listen to myself, but when I talk to myself, you know, I'm just here talking and testing, I talk lower. Whereas when I talk to you, I'm so excited. Oh yeah. I'm going to bring you a little special something today, but I got to go and make sure I get, there's a picture of the dog I did just before we got live, and I went, oh yeah, I didn't upload it so that you could see it. So let me do that really quick and hope that I hit the right button here. Oh yes, that was it. Okay, I'm going to show you that. But you know, I did tell you yesterday that yesterday I wore what I was going to wear on Good Friday, and then today it's my Easter outfit. Now, I would not have worn this to church on Easter. Okay, get that? Because, you know, I'm a greeter. However, wouldn't you just love it if you saw me show up with this? Yeah, that is the shirt that I was going to wear on Easter. Don't you just love it? You know, I mean, wouldn't that make you feel like you were going to get ready for some great thing to happen in church if that one of the greeters had this on? You know, spoiler alert, here's the end of the story. Yeah, well, it's lovely to see all you there. And, you know, and Friday was sad, but, you know, Sunday's coming. And, you know, for us, Sunday's here, okay? Because I really like to do stuff to speak life into your life and like, make you, you know, give you a little laugh. I mean, oh, my goodness, you know, I could feel down if I wasn't going to hang out with you every day. Well, every weekday. So, hey, thank you so much for tuning in. And if you have not already, you know, tell your friends about it. Oh, I keep going to the wrong side. That side. Yeah. And, you know, thank you for the subs. Thank you for the hearts. Yeah. And thank you for the thumbs up because, you know, only computers run this, all this stuff. And there's real people behind it. And all they do is look at numbers. And they, you know, yeah, they look at things like that. Me, I'm just glad you're here. So I want to show you the card that I got, and here it is. Not that one. Nope, that's later. I am going to give a card away today. Yep. I think that's better. And I'm finding that even if I have your address, it's a lot easier. You know, if you're a viewer and not a client, it's easier if you just go and email me your address if you win. When you win, how about that? Yeah, and that's my email address right there. When you win, and I'll do that up at the end when we have the drawing, because the way I have to do my labels is different now, and yeah, I have to type them all in fresh, and that's okay. I'll do it for you. Yeah, you know what? I look better in a hat when my hair's dirty, but today it's clean. So did you wear your Easter hat today? Did ya? Did ya? I mean, I don't want to be the only one here with an Easter hat. I don't want to be the only one here with an Easter hat. Come on. Like I said, this was not going to be the one I was going to wear. But here is the card that Diane sent. And Diane's frequently on here. I don't know if she's on here today. I haven't seen her yet. But isn't that nice? And I love this stamp set. Yep. And yeah, she put, you know, she stamped and wrote inside. So there you go. And Diane's on my team. But she started out watching this just like you. Yeah. Watching it just like you. And this is the card that we're going to send to Kay, who won yesterday. Now, Kay's in a Good Friday service right now. She's not at the church. She's watching it. You know, so she knows she can watch me on the replay. And for all the replay viewers, hey, we're glad you're here too. Oh, Diane, there you are. She's here. She's here. Hey, yep. And look at her little, oh, wow. That's funny. I see one picture up here that you must have changed recently, but the system picked up her face picture. So there. But this is the card that I made at 3 o'clock this morning. And it was fun because I was watching things. So the reason I brought up Diane, I was going to bring her up anyway, but this is going to be more of an empowering thing, hopefully. Because, oh, how about this? Okay, I'm, yeah, look at, she's, she went away, but anyway, she washed her hair for Good Friday too, yeah. You know, the longer my hair gets, the more I have to wash it, and I was down to, like, every other day, and now I might have to go to every day, because then it hides things that you might see otherwise. Yay! Okay, so Anita got her ornate bundle, and that's what we use to make this. This, oh, hello. This and this are from the ornate bundle. This is in the regular catalog, and I am taking a shining to Terracotta Tile. Let's see, you know, is he in the frame? Is he in the frame? Yes, there he is. Hi, Stamper. Except for you've got a cable here. You could tell I was working on stuff last night. There you go. Yeah, that means he's working extra hard. So here's what happened. Diane went and took me out of there, not him. She had mentioned on the dog's Facebook page that I had sent her a card a while back. Now, I knew I must have sent it to the right person because she kept it. And when she, you know, she showed it to me and I was like going, well, I remember that card because I really do, but I don't remember how I made it. So, you know, and she didn't know how I made it either. So, I mean, come on. Things happen. We've blinked since then. So, yeah, because when you see where this is, you know, you're going to go, oh, wow. Okay. So anyway, so I'm gonna talk you through this so you can go and find out a lot of things. Because the blog, I've had the blog for 14 years now, right? 14 years. Now, the very beginning of the blog, it's okay. I mean, I've got pictures of it, but it wasn't programmed like it is now. And then I went to TypePad, and those are in there, but they don't really look, the pages, you know, they don't look this quite the same as the ones when I went over to the format that I use now, which I've used for several years. And like I said, I've blinked since then, so I don't remember how long. It's been at least 8, I think, that I've been on this platform. And so anyway, but you can search things, and I'm going to show you how right now. So here is the blog, right? And we're going to show you how we made the card, and you're going to see the card that Diane likes so much. So you can see where today I went and I showed the card that we're going to send to. Hold on, where's my water? There it is. I need another sip. Sorry. To Kay. Kay won yesterday. And so here's this, but it's just got the last few posts, okay? And then you can go here and you can see all the blog posts, right? But up here in the top where it says search, we knew that it said, oh golly, it'd be nice if I had a it would be nice if I had a keyboard here. Yeah. We knew that at the in the on the front of the card it said delightful, right? So I went to this and I searched it, because most of the cards I make I put on the blog. And so here are all that, look at, that's when we had Delightful Dijon, and these are just different cards using that where I use the words delightful. Now look, this was an eye opener to me when I looked. That is, that was a First Friday sale, and that was a year and a half ago. So we've been doing those for a while now. Okay, so then I go here, and I'm looking, and I'm going, okay, that's not it, that's not it. But you know, there, you know that if it has the word delightful in it, it's going to have something good. And boom, there it is. Stamping out of my comfort zone and a secret. And here is, that's the card she loved. And lucky for us, I went and put directions on how to do it, which we don't always do. So today we're going to follow my own directions and see where it leads us. Now, we know it's not a boom or bust thing, okay? It's not a boom or bust thing, but and there's things that I remember. But this said to cut it down to 5 by 4 3/4. So did I do that? No, I cut it. I cut it a quarter inch smaller, because I know the greeting that I'm going to put on here is smaller. And today you're not going to see the whole thing, because, you know, tomorrow I'll put it on the blog and you'll see the finished card, because there is some drying time here. Now I know that before we started, I brought out, da-da-da! Hold on. Now the trick with these, I keep going back and forth, sorry. The trick with these, cut it in half and then cut it each side in three, or just cut it in half and cut it in half. We used to have them slightly different with the rounded, rounded corner, right? But now they have these little square corners. So when in these ones with the rounded corners, they went really well into sixth. With this, they're a little bit small for sixth. But the good thing about cutting them down is that I can use this, you know, I mean, it's several sides of it. And they're only like $3.50 for three of them, or some ridiculous, it's less than $4, right, for three of them. And look at, I'm going to get like up to 18 sponges and several sides to each sponge. So for me, it's a no-brainer that I can just go and throw it away if I need to. You know, I mean, it's, I'm not going to cry because, but I could wash it if I wanted to. It just depends on how careful you are. So let's get out the colors of ink that I used, because it's going to be slightly different. The greeting isn't available, but I have a good one too already. Except for that, I put it away. Okay, so we have... Golly, what color was that? I know that's in there. Pool party. Yeah. This looks gray under that red light. And that's Pear Pizzazz. Yeah, my new light came in, so I moved them around. And I like it, because that one's not as hot, but I can still feel it. So what they said is that first we sponge Pear Pizzazz from the outside towards the center, from either end of the watercolor paper. Now, because I'm going to be using the Stamparatus with this, I should kind of, hold on, let's see if I can move the, I'm going to try and move this to there. Now I can see what you have to say. Hold on. I'm trying to see all your stuff and... You know, I'm trying to see two different screens that are not two different screens, but two different windows. And I didn't think about this part. There you go. Hey, Tony's here. Life is good. Okay, now where was I? Here we go. Okay, so what I did was you're going to take some pear pizzazz and go in from the outside. And that's that. I'm just doing what I said, so I'm having to read my own instructions. I'm not having a professional write them for me. So this could look totally different or totally the same. Boy, it already, yeah. I remember that card, though, because it's not really, I usually don't do messy stuff. Okay, and I'm going to go from here. I'm not looking at the picture. I'm just looking at the instructions and you. Yeah, wow, that's already darker. I'm going to tell you that. Okay. And then I went and sponged Pool Party in the middle, blending it with the Pear Pizzazz. Okay. And part of this is just going to be a test. And by the way, this is watercolor paper. This is our fluid watercolor paper that we carry. That's the size. And half of that, let me see the size of this. Because we've had different sizes throughout the years. If you cut it in half, it's 3.5 by 5. What's that? And I cut this a little bit smaller. So 3.5, if you cut this in half, look at, you get two of these out of one sheet. And Stamp It Up doesn't play when they come to accessories. They like test everything. So see, there's the pool, the Pear Pizzazz side, and this is going to be the Pool Party side. Now, if you don't have re-inkers, I highly recommend them, because especially if you're going to be sponging. Because if you're going to be sponging, then, boy, I'm already darker. You're sucking up a lot of ink into this sponge. Okay, now here's where it gets interesting. We could call this the clean card, right? And there's a couple different ways to do it, and we're going to do it those couple ways. But let me go and get... You know, I like to keep my little area dry. Okay, here's a secret. You know all this is a piece of 12 by 12 black cardstock. And every now and then I buy some. There you go. You want to get 70% alcohol. Not necessarily from the grocery store. Not, you know, it could be anything, you know, but anyway, 70%. And if you're going to be cleaning and stuff like that, you know, cleaning your house and you want something clean, 70% alcohol kills everything. 91 is really strong, but 70%, you know, hey, it works. So we're only going to use a little bit of this. Now, when I did it, I'm almost positive that I had a big spritzer, right? But today I only have one of these little spritzers, and I filled this just before we started, and I tried to do it over this, because you know how something is the very first time when you open the bottle, and especially with something like this, as soon as you hold it, it spurts out. So I tried to catch as much as I could there, so that we have a couple different options to see how this is going to work. But we sell these for, I think, $2 for $3.50. And I couldn't find my one with a W on it, or an A on it. I have one with a W. Now, a lot of the time when you go and they tell you to spritz water on something, I'm going to tell you, 70% alcohol works really well. 70% alcohol. And the reason is because it dampens your cardstock. It breaks down the fibers and it dries quickly. Whereas water might take a little while. So are you getting this right now? And the reason that I went in from the side here, is because I wanted it to have a bit of an edge. If you don't want that edge, then just go like this and work out, okay? So we're going to try it a couple different ways, because if you look at the original card, and I'm going to, well, I let's try that. And here, if you look at the original card, right? See, I did do it kind of dark, but not as dark as today. Those little dots are kind of big, right? Yeah, they're kind of big. So we'll see how it works with this. Now I got to figure out how to make that go back to where I can see what you're saying. See, Liz is over there saying, you know, she likes to use alcohol. Not red wine. Okay, not red wine. So, oh, golly. You know, I have a little box, and I'm going to throw it away because I have lots of boxes. Stamp it up, you know, the UPS guy knows me, you know. And but I used to have a box. Oh, my goodness, it's still over there. Maybe I'll bring it out. Well, you know, let me go get that. Let me go get that. Just a sec. Well, here, let me spray it first. Well, first of all, I'm going to spray it on my hand. There, okay. See, this is doing little spots. I know it's not necessarily gonna do what I want. See, it's making like little pools, and that's not where I'm going. So I'm gonna go get that little thing, and I'm gonna show you something you could do if you wanted something all the time. I mean, it's within in my sight, but there's like a little obstacle course here. Because I haven't thrown it away yet. But you can tell, you know, as much as I don't like to do messy things, look at, see? And we actually sold, I don't know if Stampin' Up! Sold these, or I just bought it at a store. Hello. But see, when you're doing metallics and things like that, you definitely want to have a spray box, okay? Spray box. No, you want it, now she's asking Tony, but, yeah, splat box. She's asking Tony, but it's 70%. You know, I don't see all this. Yeah, 70. Yep, see, look at Tony. Tony's smart. She hangs out with me. Okay, so now here's something that I know is in here. Ta-da! Aqua Painters. Now, this has water in it, so, yeah. That's why I have this little thing here. Right? Because I knew it had water in it. And that's not hair down in the bottom. That's actually, that's cracks. So that's why I was like, yeah, I'll use it in there. And this is going to, this might work better. Because I had splots on that. Okay, now, see, that's what you're going for. Little splots. So maybe one of those travel sprayers. I'm getting it all over everything. One of those little travel sprayers is, see there, I got splots. They're going to show up later, I'm sure. And hold on. You know, I quit looking at the instructions a long time ago. Here's the other thing. Hold, let me go and paper towel. I know they're here. You might hear this because it's attached to the microphone. You always go and clean this off, right? Because right now it's got alcohol in it, and so I'm gonna push some of the water through it. You know, just push some of the water through it so that it'll rinse out that alcohol, because I'm going to be using it with a re-inker now. Because I'll bet you that I did that too. Who knows? Who knows? That's kind of like how this card started. I saw something that looked something totally different than what I showed. Totally different than how it ended up. And then you start to go, oh, I kind of like that idea. And go in the other room, make it. You have it, your own idea. So, I know there was some, see, there's none in the bottom of this. No reinker in the bottom of that. But I know there is in the bottom of this. Now remember, I'm going to finish this tomorrow, but you know, I could just go and take this and there's no law saying that I just can't play with this until it's bending to my will. Because I'm not, those splots just didn't want to show up like they did. So I'm wondering if I did this. Oh, please let's not, let's not let this splatter everywhere. Doesn't want to do that. Maybe if I release some of the water with it. There you go. Might work easier with a brush. Boy, it's just little. Is this thing not releasing any water? Is that it? Because it's just been sitting there too long? I don't know. Well, you know what? I'm going to dry that out. So I'm going to add some of the alcohol to... That's what I'm doing. I'm dipped it because this... I think the O-ring got dry because I hadn't used it in a while. I have several of these around. Some of them are like 10 years old. And I made it really wet. This will clean out of here really easily. So don't worry about that. And this... It just wants to hold... Oh, there we go. Let's try that. I don't like to do that because my fingers. Oh, wow. We're getting a little bit of... Now, I could add... If I wanted those to be darker, I could go and add more re-inker. So, see, as much... These kind of things, they're really more like a science project. There, now it's going, it's getting, and I really kind of want it subtle. I don't really want, but I guess I'm going to try and add some more. Ha, 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 ha. Now, let me tell you, speaking as a voice of experience, right? Make sure you always check what the name is on there. See, it's pool party. It's don't ask me how I know. Yeah, I've re-inked things with the wrong ink. Now, if you're trying to be really frugal, and there's nothing wrong with being frugal, then you can go and rinse the pad out and re-ink it. For me, it's just worth the... I'll just give them the money and buy a new one. See, look at... If you have more in there... Now I've got so many sprinkles, I don't know what to do with it. Oh! It's got freckles! Yeah, oh, yeah, they're backordered. You can still get them, I guess, yeah. Who's got the number? Yeah, who's got the number? So now I got sprinkles everywhere on this. And as always, like I said, you want to go and clean this off. Now, you don't just clean it off. You press and there should be water coming out, but there isn't water coming out. So I'll go and look at this one. Like I said, some of my aqua painters are 10 years old. They could be 15 for all I know, because I bought them as soon... The very first time I saw an aqua painter, I went, oh, God, I have that. Because, you know, you can just pick up one color and then just clean it off on your paper towel. And the other thing is that you don't want to go and You see a lot of people go and dry these off on their grid pads. I really think that that's a bad habit, because if you dry it on your grid pad, you know, and maybe you use it by the sheet. I put the whole pad underneath it. I've got a whole pad underneath this black sheet of paper, or cardstock. When you do that, one day, maybe not tomorrow, but one day you're going to put a folded white card base on top of that damp spot. And then when you go to put your card together, you're going to go, how did this get here? And it's because you went and dried this or changed colors on your grid pad and not a paper towel. Now, this paper towel, although they're very, very valuable right now, you could use a paper towel for a long time and don't have to throw it away. Like this one, it could sit here for a long time. So it's not like I'm being wasteful or anything. But see, and it, you don't do it until it's clean, because it's probably never going to get clean. It'll change as long as it doesn't come out on your skin. Hold on. Like this. See, look at this. It has the blue on it now. And I'm going like this. It's not coming off on my skin. And guess what? It just gives you another reason to wash your hands. Yeah, sanitizer break. Yeah. So there you go. You know what? We could make this. Let's do this. Now, I'm going to show you ways to avoid issues. How about that? You like avoiding issues? Now, remember, I wasn't planning on this part, so this is the stamp set. I know I have this. We could even use this, but I don't think so. I know you're not supposed to touch your face, but I'm home. That's the other thing. When you go out somewhere, just make sure you wash your hands when you come home. That's really the most important thing. You know, wash your hands when you come home. Wash your hands before you go. Yeah. Yeah, that's dry. Now, you do know our heat tool does have two speeds to it. It's got one that does for embossing, and then the lower speed is good for something like this. Because if you were going over here and reading my my instructions, you know, it says that I dried it and then I put a big block on it to keep it flat. But we didn't get it that wet. And it says later I use the heat tool to on low speed to dry it, you know, speed up the drying process. So stamps. Okay. I know it's here. I have to know where I put it. There it is. I knew I put it somewhere close by, because nothing's too far away. Okay, now, if you were here when I talked about never, you know, they talk about don't tempt fate. I'm talking about I'd never gone and broken one of these. I did. And do you know, I was holding this like, look how far away I am. I'm at least 5 inches, right, away. I can feel the pull. That's how careful you have to be. And you could probably go bang, bang, bang several times. And then all of a sudden, one time is going to go. If you choose to use them once they're broken, make sure you cover the cut end, you know, the broken end, with some washi tape. Because I noticed there's little slivers in that. And I'm sure I don't want to step on that, right? Yeah. And I don't want the dog to eat it. So make sure I recovered them the other night, because I noticed I went, this is kind of sharp, you know. So, yeah. When you're going on the edge, you want to make it swing away, right? I'm doing this upside down. I'm just putting it here, and this is going to be my... this is going to be my top, right? And I'm only doing it this way because this is a bumpy paper, and you may not get a good press. Otherwise, I'd just go and take, you know, something, just, you know, stamp it. But I want to get it right, because when I did the original card, I wrote in there about how I didn't get a good press on that solid stamp. And I'll show this again in case you were just getting here. I didn't get a good press, so I had to go in and fill in with a marker. Now, this is the stamp set that we used. Hold on 1 second. There you go. It's supposed to do that. There you go. That's the stamp. That's the original stamp set. Now, I put that where I want it. Put this bumpy side down. I have to think about my fingers because you look at them too much. Oh, this is fun. I'm not only having to look at two screens, I'm having to look at two windows on two screens. Wow. Put the ink, the stamp set underneath it, right? Oh yeah, and before I do that, gotta pick it up. There you go. And yeah, this, you don't see this, but just know that I'm gonna ink it up with Memento ink, because Memento ink works well with alcohol, and even if it is a little bit, now I'm gonna give it just a little bit extra time to get let the ink drop off of the stamp and onto the paper, only because it's very porous paper. Oh, bingo! So now, let's see. Nope, that's not where I want it. I just want to put it someplace I can replace it. Oh, that's a new one. That's a new one. Stick it in these little grids. It just has to be in a spot where I can, if it doesn't happen, then I can redo it. Don't like this. This is not working for me. There, come on. Do 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 do. Yeah, something like that. Still put a little bit higher. Yep. Long as I don't drop it. Now, when you drop it, you are committed, or should be. Oh, hi, Barbara. Yeah, you can watch this on the replay. We're just glad you're here. Glad you're all here. And I hope, it's really interesting. You know, I know that this virus is a really controversial thing. I realize that. Just try to play along. Try to play along, because you don't want to. It's one of those things, you don't want to be on the wrong side of the way it works out. You know, I know someone that went, they're just going too far. They're just going too far. They don't, it's not where I want it. Oh, did you hear that? Hold on, I'll show you. See? I had this one in my hand, and I put my other hand over by where that one was. And yeah, it doesn't have to be straight, but I'm just trying to get a line here. Anyway, it's just one of those things that you don't want to be thinking, oh yeah, no, you don't have to do anything. You know, they're just blowing this all up. And then all of a sudden, boom, you got it. You know, So just be careful. And by the way, we did try, besides that mask I showed you, we went and folded up some scarves. I got some scarves, and yeah, those work too. Just imagine going into the bank and saying, I'd like some money, please. Sorry if this is a little off screen. There you go. Yeah, you know what? Here's one thing. Even if you're not using a Stamparatus, when you're using something bumpy, it's a good idea to have like a pokey tool mat underneath, and give it a little bit extra time for the ink to drop off the stamp. Because, you know, the other thing is use your grid pad to go and do test stops, you know? It's coming together. Okay. Now this might take a little bit longer. So I want to ask each one of you while I go get the greeting. I want to ask you, what are you having on Sunday? Are you having a special meal? Are you having it shipped in? Are you, you know, what are you doing? Golly, if somebody can remember what the stamp set is, I could find it really easy because they're all alphabetized. It is not coming to me. It is not coming to me. And as soon as I go off, it's going to. Because remember, I wasn't planning on doing this part. But the deal was, if you do and you can learn just from this. I'm going to put a bold greeting right here. And I'm going to, I believe that I went and did this with a dauber. And let me try that real quick. Oh, wow. We're having short ribs. Only because that's what we already bought. Had nothing to do with the day. But my friend is sending over Easter dinner. So, you know, we don't really... Yeah. Oh, and I didn't show you yesterday's project. Now, I'm taking old olive because it's darker, right? Yeah. I don't know if that we did it in the first one. Tony's having a normal meal. You know what? Mac and cheese is something that I have not mastered yet. I think that I took this and I went and... I think I took it and I actually colored it in with... Either that or I had the stamp. Well, how about this? You know, this is just too much like right. Yeah, look on the stamp set. It's got a center. But you know what? I'm committed now. Or should be. Oh, lots of ham. I only have ham when... on occasions. You know what? I can't say I don't like this. I could have done that with some yellow too. It is not going to be the same as the original card. I don't mind. But in the holiday or not holiday catalog, it does have, there's a stamp set there that has greetings. And you know, I took my catalog, it's usually right here underneath me. I took it out and went over and I was using it when I was writing everything, you know, for the blog post, and it's like going, okay, great, because I don't know the name of that set, and I don't want to go, you know, if you look over here, I'd have to go through all those right there. I went through some, you could see them, but yeah, you know how it is. You regulars know that, hey, I know I can look tomorrow at the blog and she'll have it done. So let's find someone to give a card to, and I'm probably going to send this card out in the mail today. How about that? Would you like that? And it'll be reusable so that you can go and, you know, write whatever you want inside and send it off to someone else and bless someone who has not been, you know, been able to get out. Because you're getting out. I mean, you're here with me, right? So let me put on my lucky hat. I'm so glad you guys came. You know, you have no idea. You are just the reason for my existence. Well, that and my daughter and my husband and grandkids. And, of course, the dog. Oh, golly, we're going to her house, Stamper. Look at that. Whoa. Yes, Cindy sent over some, Cindy sent over some oranges, and she has the best tree in town. So let's see. Oh, golly, yeah, I went and, thank you for not closing that. Okay, so we have 80. Hello? Why did I bring a phone in here? I'll never know. I have no idea who it is, but I've got two phones in here going on. I said 92, didn't I? Well, Nancy, I'm not taking your call right now. Boy, that's the first time I've ever put the keyboard behind me. 92. Who is it? Number 44. Who's that? By the way, if you saw something that you liked today, you know, hey, go over and so the dog can eat. He likes doing that. Golly, Ann Clemmer, it's, I put it in a separate window and it's like, I'm looking for your, there we go. 44, right? 1, 2, 3. Ha, ha, ha. And of all comments of this to me, this is funny. Of all comments, this is the one. Liz, you're so great. And I know she's here and I've got her address. So I'm going to look for that in the mail next week. And you know what? Go out and have a really great time this weekend. And whether you're just getting together with family or you're looking for a church and you can't go into the building, I'll put a couple links of two ministers I know that really give great messages. One's at 10 o'clock Pacific time, one's at 11 o'clock Pacific time. And of course, they do the replays just like me. This is Ann Clemmer and Stamper from stamperdog.com, where we try to put a little ink, paper, and fun
yes,
into your day.